Well, what do you know? Marvel Comics is back in the headline-making business, free of having to march in line or at least coordinate with Kevin Feige's Marvel Studios as the two infamously, just last month, parted ways. What am I talking about? Well, they made some serious headlines with their new highly acclaimed author that they've put onto Black Panther. And now today, they're making some serious headlines with the announcement that the Daredevil creative team of Mark Waid and Chris Samnee are going to be taking over the solo Black Widow title, which has gotten Black Widow trending on Twitter. Why, ironically? Because everybody thinks that this might lead to a Black Widow movie. Because let's be honest, the number of people who read comics in relation to the number of people who see the movies is pretty disparate. So everybody's excited because what this might mean for the MCU. But again, they're separate now. Marvel Comics and Marvel TV, the TV division, have stayed together, but Kevin Feige has taken the movies out of that sandbox. And I think it's interesting that you either have one of two things happening here, or both, and that's that Marvel Comics is pushing back and making the kind of headlines that fans wish that Marvel Studios would make about characters like Black Panther and Black Widow. Or also maybe they're just free now to not have to, you know, coordinate with what's happening in the movies, right? They're like, fine, you don't want to play with us? We're going to go back to doing telling awesome stories in the pages of our comics, which is really, I think, a win-win in both cases for the viewers. Now, as I said, this doesn't guarantee a Black Widow movie, although I do have, in honor of this announcement, 5 ideas for a Black Widow movie to prove that it can be done. But I think this is an important step towards a Black Widow movie for, again, 2 reasons. One, it shows people that, particularly those working at Disney and Marvel Studios, that there continues to be intense demand for this character to have a solo movie. And that's, indicated by interest in her solo title. Then the other thing is that when you look into Black Widow's history as a character, she's really only been supporting. She does not have a rich history from which to draw. So that doesn't give to what at this point has been very continuity friendly franchise, the MCU, anything to work with. Now, some people might see that as a gift, right? Like, you can create the Black Widow, character in her universe because nobody else has. But apparently that's a step that Kevin Feige nor anyone at Marvel Studios wants to take. So if they can create some stronger and richer mythology in the comics, then that might help increase the argument for a movie. Now, before I get to my 5 ideas, let's just talk about this comic book for a moment. And I think it's interesting, by the way, that in the covers released, she's Black Widow is sporting the short haircut that Joss Whedon so famously gave her, and which the Russo brothers apparently do not like, because whenever they get the chance, I guess Black Widow likes extensions because nobody can grow their hair that fast, they make her hair as long and silky and shiny and Pantene commercially as they can. But they're obviously going with the Joss Whedon-y version, which is good because I think Joss Whedon's done the most with the character to date. Although the Winter Soldier, I think, did a lot to up her cool factor, and also some people didn't like what Joss Whedon did with her in Avengers Age of Ultron, so we'll see. But anyway, again, Mark Waid and Chris Samnee are the creative team. If you haven't read their run on Daredevil, you are missing out. I think they largely, it's ironic, they had to leave Daredevil because they want the title at Marvel to be more reflective of what's going on with the Netflix series. So it's a little bit brighter and happier. So what Mark Waid and Chris Samnee did, although that's interesting, they would put them over on Black Widow, but they had to go so they could get a title that's, you know, more indicative of what's happening over on Netflix. So now they're gonna go and make a new title on this new Black Widow series, which it's been running with other creative talent and nobody's paid attention to it. I've tried to read it. It's not good. But, you know, to try and spur a movie. So it's just funny to see the way things work. But anyway, some people say, so read that Daredevil run, by the way. It's really spectacular. But some people are saying, that's a lot of men on a Black Widow book. And I just think, I'd like to say that while I think it's important to have diversity behind the camera just as much as in front of the camera, and I'm not just talking about ethnicity, we're talking about age and gender, but I don't think that means that only people who are like the characters can work on those properties. I think that it's going to keep certain characters, diverse characters, from getting into the limelight and getting their own movies if they can only be, their stories can only be told by a specific group of people that are like them. I think that's, you know, really hinders it. And I think we've seen, for instance, I think a great example recently is the Hunger Games franchise, which has a very strong female lead, obviously, Katniss Everdeen, played by Jennifer Lawrence. And that is an entirely male creative team behind the camera. Frances Lawrence has directed the last three films, done a spectacular job, on the two what we've seen. I see no reason he'd totally mess up the last one. And then Danny Strong has written both of the Mockingjay scripts, co-written them. And then also on Catching Fire, you had Simon Beaufoy, a really celebrated screenwriter, also just worked on The Martian, and Michael Arndt from like Toy Story 3. So while I don't want to hinder opportunities for people to get out there, but I also think that if you are not a white dude working in Hollywood, you don't want to only tell stories about people like yourself, right? I mean, that's not going to be fun for anyone. So I think it's too inhibitive on both characters and talent. So I think that we're really trying to get a Black Widow solo movie here, and I think that the knee-jerk reaction of like, what's with the dudes on the book, is counterproductive. All right, so anyway, what are my ideas for a Black Widow movie? Because it seems like we're moving a little bit closer, right? And many of you like to argue in the comments that there could never be a Black Widow movie. What would it be? Well, here are my suggestions, and I'd be interested to hear your suggestions down below and what you think of mine. All right, so I have five of them. It was hard to come up with five, I have to tell you. I had to really dig, but I thought about it for like 15 minutes and I came up with five. So imagine if like the people at Marvel Studios worked on it for like a day. Okay, so anyway, number one, back to the Red Room. And the Red Room is where the Black Widow operatives are trained. We've seen this hinted at now in Avengers Age of Ultron. And also this is something that the comic book, this new series that Waid and Samnee are working on, is going to explore. Black Widow is going to have to go back to her past and to the people who originally taught her how to be a spy to help her now, right? So they're gonna be fleshing out her background and something, stuff that could be obviously used in such a story. So I think that would be great, almost like a reverse origin story for Black Widow. I think that could be really cool. She's probably thinking about it now that Scarlet Witch made it pop up in her mind involuntarily. Maybe she wants to go back and explore that, see what's going on with the Red Room program today, the Black Widow program. So that's my number one idea. Number two, Black Widow versus Hydra, right? Everybody loves a good Hydra story, so why not? Hydra doesn't operate out in the open, neither does Black Widow. She's the perfect person to take them down, to expose their undercover operations, right? Where punching and, you know, lasers and a hammer, Mjolnir, just don't work. If you didn't get exactly what I was going for there. But anyway, I think it would be really interesting to have S.H.I.E.L.D. send her on an undercover spy mission, just like kind of like when she first infiltrated Stark Enterprises, right? And try and weed out some Hydra operatives, wherever they went once, you know, S.H.I.E.L.D. went away, right? At the end of Winter Soldier. So I think that'd be very interesting as well. I think that would be a great storyline. And again, people love Hydra. The movie could be full of whispering. It would be a lot of fun. So number three, the other widows. Black Widow, Natasha Romanoff, isn't the only Black Widow. There is Yelena Belova, who took over the mantle of Black Widow after Natasha defected to the United States. And she, very patriotic to the Soviet Union still. And that we could do something that reflects what the Soviet Union has become today. For instance, I just watched recently the 60 Minutes interview with Vladimir Putin. And it was fascinating because it was like this new animal of like thinly veiled, you know, like Cold War-isms, but yet still trying to be more open because, you know, the Cold War isn't supposed to really be around anymore, right? So it was really interesting to watch. So I think that would be very cool indeed. So you could have a Black Widow versus a new Black Widow. And then also Marvel Comics just introduced a new character called Red Widow, which is like a teenage Black Widow. Kind of think like Spider-Gwen, right? I don't know why they did that. I'd be like, you know, we're trying to help Black Widow. It doesn't help if you dilute the pool of widows, right? You already have Yelena, but Red Widow, they could find some way to do it. So you have a whole widow movie, and it could kind of be like the recent Taylor Swift music video, Bad Blood, and just have all these widows fighting it out and looking awesome while doing so. I think that could sell tickets, right? Now, number four is a Winter Soldier adventure, right? I mean, in the comics, they're a couple, right? Because think about it. Both of them were broken by Russia and then rebuilt as monsters. I mean, they have a lot to talk about. You know, she, you know, put the moves on Hulk, who we'll get to in a moment, because she felt he was also a monster. But, she hasn't really talked that much, you know, to Bucky, right? Because they only started to be introduced at the end of Winter Soldier, and he actually, you know, went away. Only Steve really talked to him. So I don't think she's aware of how much they have in common, right? Like, if they were both on Match.com, they would check all the same boxes. They might have to do other and then fill in brainwashed by the KGB, turned into an assassin, and I hate myself because of it. And they're like, wow, there's someone else like that. So they're like, kind of like in the comics, they've been like the Nick and Nora Charles. And it's been interesting because they flashed back to his training, and Black Widow, before she defected, was involved in that training. So maybe that's a deep secret that the MCU version of Black Widow harbors, right? Maybe she didn't tell everything to Steve Rogers when he first confronted her in the hospital, because Black Widow doesn't spill her guts, you know, at the first opportunity. So I think that could be really, really interesting. I would like that quite a bit. And, you know, Captain America, by the way, Black Widow is always trying to set him up. So I think Captain America kind of owes her and could be like, look, Steve could be like, you're always trying to set me up on dates, Natasha. Let me set you up with Bucky, all right? And let me do a major solid for Bucky. Bucky would be like, you're the best friend ever. All right, but then, of course, number five is Brutasha, the Hulk, right? Our superhero celebrity couple. We were very excited for them in Avengers Age of Ultron. I was, at least. I didn't quite like the way it played out. I thought it was a little bit of a letdown, but that doesn't mean I'm willing to give up on it, right? Bruce Banner disappeared. Let her go after him, or let him come to her, and they could have an adventure together. And I think that might, just maybe, if, you know, he's a supporting character in a Black Widow movie, get around the whole Universal problem if they have the rights to any solo Hulk films, right? Problem solved. And who wouldn't see a Black Widow Hulk movie? It's insane. It would do incredibly well. So those are my five ideas, and they could either be five solo awesome movies, or you could take all those elements, roll them into one, and make the mother of all Black Widow movies. It would be, I think, amazing. And if you still don't agree that you can make a Black Widow movie after my suggestions, I would love to hear your counter arguments down below. And also, are you going to read the Black Widow comic? Everybody's excited about it because it might lead to a movie, but do you think you'll actually purchase this comic? Is there anything that Marvel can do to increase comic book sales, not just the ticket sales of comic book movies? Write your thoughts down below. Thank you so much for tuning in, and you can check out some other episodes right now.